Hello, welcome to Savvy's Kitchen. In this video, I am going to show you how to make ragi malt powder at home and how to prepare ragi malt or ragi amli or sari as we call it for babies. Finger millet or ragi is a great source of calcium. For this recipe, I have taken 1/2 kg of ragi and I am going to dry roast it. This ragi powder can be used as a weaning food for babies between 6 to 9 months, and if you want to start early on, ragi is supposed to cause constipation in few babies. Make sure to give additional 1 or 2 spoons of water when you feed this ragi malt powder for babies. So let us know how to prepare this ragi powder at home. After you dry roast it, these few millets will pop up like this, as I have shown here, and it is ready for grinding. For this recipe, I am also adding few Indian spices like few cardamom, and then 1/2 teaspoon of jeera, and 1/2 teaspoon of methi, and few black pepper seeds. And we have to dry roast these ingredients also. So I am going to show here. Once you do this for 3 to 5 minutes, we can add these Indian spices to this ragi and grind it together. I have not used any nuts and pulses for this powder, as they should always be tried individually for babies when they are between 6 to 9 months. In next video, I am going to show you how to make similar protein malt powder at home for babies and adults. So please hit the notification bell if you are new here. Once you dry roast these spices, add them to ragi and make it into a smooth powder. We can store it in an airtight container and it can be used for up to 2 months. For babies between 6 to 9 months, 2 to 3 tablespoons of ragi powder can be used per day. First, we have to make slurry out of this ragi powder. For this, I have taken 3 tablespoons of ragi powder and adding water to it. For babies below 1 year, animal milk should always be avoided to prevent allergies. So, I am going to make this recipe with water. So, make sure that there are no lumps in this slurry. And once you make a thin slurry like this, heat it over a low flame and stir continuously. Keep stirring it continuously, and after 5 minutes this slurry will start to thicken. Once it becomes a thick or semi-solid in consistency, it will start becoming glossy. Then you can add a 1 tablespoon of ghee. Ghee is known to have some laxative effect on gut of the baby, so it is always good to add 1 tablespoon of ghee in most of baby foods. So here I am going to add 1 tablespoon of ghee to this mixture. Now this is almost ready, and we have to make sure that this will cool down well before feeding it to the babies. Hope you enjoyed watching this video, and this video was informative for you all. If you are new here, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit the notification bell for all upcoming videos. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye.